Good Friday evening, everybody. Come on in. Believe it or not, I'm on Friday night. I'm cooking, so I haven't had my day off from cooking yet. I cooked this morning, remember? So here I go. I'm cooking again. So here we go. I got some thin sliced chicken breasts, and I am going to be dipping them into some buttermilk and then into some flour, and then we're going to fry them in some olive oil, and I'm going to cook some hash brown potato patties. So we're gonna have something fried up here tonight. So I got about I think 4 or 5 pieces of this chicken breast. It's probably one. I bought a package of them, thought that was cut up in smaller pieces, but they weren't. So anyway, I just cut them in half, and I'm going to dip them, like I said, into my buttermilk bath here. I think my oil is hot enough, y'all. Medium high heat, just medium, a little bit below medium. I tell you, last night Karan called me, bless his little heart. He wanted some a steak, so I told him how. But you know, you have to be very careful with high heat, y'all. And I'm gonna tell you that. Low heat means low heat when it comes to cooking, especially if you're dealing with butter. Okay, get these all dredged into this buttermilk bath. And this will make a nice little crust. And you know, you don't have to cook these chicken breast pieces not too long, about 2 or 3 minutes, and they're done. And then I'm gonna drop those potatoes into the same pan. I was talking to somebody last night, and then we were talking about cooking stuff, and she said to me, yeah, I don't do a whole lot of cooking for one thing, she said, because I believe in one pan cooking. I said, well, yeah, that's good. Because those one dish meals are good during the summer. She said, I mean all the time. So I got tickled. So this is one of those one dish meals here, y'all. So I'm gonna go ahead and start dropping these in. I've got most of them, but I think I'll get all of them in the same pan. So let's go ahead and drop the first one in. Oh yeah. And you don't want them cooking real fast. As low as you can get the heat, but yet hot enough, because you gotta let the grease heat up, and then you sort of back it back down, y'all. Okay. Alrighty. I guess I forgot to cut one of those, but that's fine. We'll be okay with these. Just like this. Now for this one, I got one more to go. Oh, did I even put that one in the milk? Let's put this in the milk to make sure we got the buttermilk on that one. I don't think I even put that one in the buttermilk. It is now. And I'm going to tell you just a second. Let me get this done. Okay, here we go. I got them in the pan. Let me clean up my mess. This will distract me if I don't. Clean that little mess off of there. Okay. There we are. So now we got them in the pan, and we're gonna cook them not slow, but you know, we don't want to cook them real fast because we don't want them to get brown before they get done in the middle. We're trying to make room for one more. Kind of stuck a little bit. That's okay. It'll be okay. Kind of stick. You know what I told y'all about cooking, things happen sometimes. I don't know why that's trying to stick, but it sure did try to stick. Y'all see it right there, didn't you? Just scrape it right up, it'll be okay. And I'm going to show you what I'm going to do for the other side to make sure it does not stick on me at all. Where there's a will, there's a way. So hope y'all having a godless Friday evening. I'm so excited too. I just came back from Lauren was in a summer dance group at a dance company right up the street. And Kanye and I went. She did so well. I wanted to get out there and dance with her. She was dancing as part of a hip hop dance group. Okay. And those other babies that were, you know, those dance schools, they have all different ages, and they had, you know, looked like maybe from 3 or 4 years old, up to maybe, because Lauren's 17. So all the way up, for that young lady that works with those, she did an excellent job, especially working with those babies. And you know, the place was crowded. It was good for the support, you know, it was really good. Really good support. It's amazing how those little babies, you know, how little ones, honey. When those little ones, honey, when they don't want to do something, guess what? They're not going to do it. They get their sleepy quiet going. And I thought about Kylie, honey. When them babies haven't had their nap, they're going to do what they're going to do. I'm going to tell you that. But it was so nice to see Lauren out there doing her hip-hop dancing. And I'm sure trying to tell y'all, Lauren got her first job. I forget what the name of the place is. But anyway, she got her first job, so we're excited and she's excited about it. So she's a working girl now. She started, I think, Monday. I am so excited because I can see it being a woman to get a job all summer. So finally, at the end of summer, time for school to start that. She got her job, y'all. And Tania, I told y'all, Tania's been working all, she told me, after dinner Sunday, she told me she's been working almost 4 years. See how time flies up so fast? I could not believe it. But anyway, both Lauren and Camille are working. They're both 17. Now, Man is 15, so next summer he'll be able to work. But Man's a football player, so I'm hoping, you know, if he's going to continue to play football, he'll find a way out of it. He wants to work, but I'm so excited his kids want to work like that, to earn their own money and start learning what it feels like to be able to reach in your own pocket and buy what you need. I think that's awesome. So anyway, my babies are not little bitty babies anymore. They're working folks now, so I'm excited about that. So we got to continue to keep these babies prayed up and keep them high with it, that they'll want to do those kind of things, like going to work and going on off college and all that kind of good stuff. Okay, let me show y'all what I said earlier. So I'm going to go ahead and spray some of this hand spray on top of these in hopes that they won't try to stick on the other side. Because I'm thinking, hopefully they'll be just sticking because they won't stick yet. So I'm going to go ahead and start turning these because I don't want them to get too brown. And when these finish, I'm going to go ahead. I've got my, these nice hash browns. I'm going to put them right in the same pan and cook them. Like my, that's how sister is my big sister. Like we were talking last night about that one big cookie. If you're watching the night shift, it's going to be that one big cookie. So I'm going to put those, potatoes, I'm going to cook them right here in the same. Oh, that was just, I don't know what that was. I thought it was sticky. It didn't stick, but just to make sure. Okay. Those are pretty and brown, don't you think? Let that cook a little bit longer. And with this, as usual, we'll probably do some kind of a salad. Maybe. All these chicken breasts, I put, of course, my... I told y'all I mix everything in my cabinet and make me a mixture of seasoning. So I put all that seasoning on there, which is onion powder, garlic powder, complete seasoning, black pepper, and paprika in there. And so I sprinkle that onto my chicken breast. And I've got a new seasoning that I'm trying out. It is called sour cream and onion seasoning. I sprinkle a little bit of that on there. We're going to see what difference that makes. So we'll be back in a few minutes. So these things are only going to take about, start to finish 10 minutes of cooking, and I'll get the potatoes going. So y'all hang tight for me. Okay, we're back. It's time for the chicken to come out. Okay. Nice and golden brown. Golden, golden, golden brown, y'all. I'm going to leave this one to fry just a little. That was the last one I put in, so gonna let it cook a little bit longer. So now, out with the chicken, in with the potatoes. So we're just gonna drop them right in there like so. Two, three, and the four. We're going to take that one out. We'll just go ahead and cook five for good measure. Five for good measure. And we're going to douse them. We can turn the heat up some now because we need these nice and crispy. So all you got to do, I'm going to try some of my new seasoning on there. Some of this sour cream and onion. Try a little bit of that on there. Just going to sprinkle it. Give it a little bit extra, a little new flavor. And then we're going to give it a little extra garlic powder. Well, now I got the garlic powder somewhere already open. Okay. Oh, it is open. I just didn't take the little deal out, did it? Okay, so these will take about a good 6 minutes, about 3 minutes on each side, because these are already cooked, and all you have to do is just brown them, I think. Yeah. Well, I want to make sure that's down good now, because we don't want this thing flying off here. Please don't fly. I want to hold it. So I'm going to put a little garlic powder on this side here and let it cook on that side. When I flip it, I will sprinkle the other side, but that's all there is to it, y'all. And of course, I'm going to put a little ground black pepper on there. Sprinkle a little bit of ground black pepper. I'm making a salad off to the side, so this is one of those Friday night meals, you know, instead of sending out for pizza or eating out, take 30 minutes to cook something right at home. As I was saying earlier about the dance recital, it was really, really good, well attended. We enjoyed Laura. She did a super duper job. And she's a working lady now, so I was thinking she might have been going to go back for the next session, but she'll be working. So we are excited to learn a hip hop dancer. Seeing her again on Sunday. Okay. We'll get that pushed over to the side. So when y'all see these again, they'll be golden brown and done and ready to eat. So this is one of those quick Friday night meals that you don't have to stay in the kitchen too long. Get it in and out, get something good to look at on TV, something cold to drink. This night, a salad with this. You can make a sandwich out of it. We just gonna eat ours because we got the potatoes and we have the chicken. And however, but you can make these will be nice chicken sandwiches if that's what you want to do. If not, just eat them with the potatoes and with the salad and make a nice Saturday night meal with a good movie or not. So, guys, I will be right back. Okay, it's time to get the potatoes out of the pan. They're nice and golden brown. We're about ready to sit down. And you know how this smells. Potatoes and onions. Oh my goodness, I got that garlic powder on them. So they are ready, y'all. Mmm, yum, yum, yum. Okay. Everything's all fried up, y'all. There it is, laid out and ready to eat. Just moved over there into frame. Isn't that just pretty? And we're gonna do a nice, a cool salad with that. Just some lettuce, and I cut up some slice. I'm not gonna put it all in because you know how sometimes tomatoes will make your, you know, get the salad kind of wet. And I'm using the last of my lettuce. So I'm just gonna cut up me a nice, I've cut up rather a nice bowl of lettuce. And I'm going to cut up my avocado and some tomato, and we're gonna call it a day. So hold on just 1 minute. Okay, this meal is ready, y'all. So thank y'all for stopping by on this Friday night. Thank y'all for your prayers, your well wishes, your comments, and your compliments, because we're gonna eat these buttermilk fried chicken breasts and those nice seasoned potato cake patties and a nice green tossed salad. Kareem, of course, we're gonna eat only lettuce, and I'm gonna eat the other veggies on mine. So we're just gonna sit back, relax, and enjoy this meal on Saturday night. Probably look at a good movie or chit chat or whatever. So guys, thank y'all for stopping by. Thank you for continuing to pray without ceasing. Keep those prayers going up now so the blessings will continue to come down, and keep praying for our children. I tell you, at that recital tonight, I was so excited to see all those little children running around and knowing that next week they're going to all be back in school again. So let's pray their safety, their well-being, and their ability to learn as much as they can while they're in school. So until I decide to cook again, y'all, love you. Toodles!